as the United States have as many North American provinces as possible.
Habibi played a perfect game last week as the Ottomans, tearing through the Mamluks with impressive ease. Deft knowledge of trade companies meant he scored higher than Corbett in this economic challenge. Off to a great start, we'll see if he can stretch that winning streak one more week. Presenting Habibi!
Welcome, once again, the dashing young man in all his glory, talking without moving his mouth.
We did actually have to obscure half of his face because it was too powerful for the Twitch.
It was too dangerous. It's like Medusa. You look at Habibi and you automatically become bad at EU4.
So you know about the challenge. How are you feeling? Have you ever played as the United States of America in 1776?
Nope. But, you know, there we go. I have a couple tricks up my sleeve. I have a couple things that I know. I think...
Okay.
And I have a backup plan as well if the first war doesn't go so well. So, I think it's gonna be a pretty interesting one. It's gonna be an interesting one today.
Yeah. Don't want to reveal that backup yet, do you? Or
you want me to just say it? Yeah, sure. I'll say it so people tell it to Flory Worry in his chat, and then it derails him and it starts getting into his head and he starts thinking
That's
about
right.
it and does
psychological
it.
Warfare.
You just accept. England's demands in the first war, and then just deck on their colonies once the truce is over, so you don't have to deal with the first war.
It's a bold strategy. It is bold. Some might call
we'll
it coward.
Or bald.
That's right. Or bald.
Well, none of us are bald.
Well, I mean, what?
Well, Habibi shaved his head.
I am literally bald right now. Well, not anymore, actually. My hair grows really fast.
All right, brag about it. Well, all right, how do you rate your chance out of 10 at beating Flory today?
Yeah, without ever playing the US.
You know, back when we first started doing Master of Universalis, Flory Worry was very confident against me. But then we played multiplayer against each other, and then he said, there was this moment where it went in his head, and he's like, you know what? Actually, Habibi's really good in multiplayer and in EU4 in some aspects. So I think he's a little anxious, just like he was last week against Levik. I think that I think this is going to be really interesting. I think that I don't want to say that my chances, I don't want to be cocky here because obviously Flory Worry is a better player than me. I'm just going to say upright when it comes to single player, he's a better player than me by far. But I don't know. I'd say a 5 out of 10, 50% chance.
50%. Well, fantastic. Well, we'll let you get ready if you don't mind starting up your game. And sharing the details with us, Hawk will be in to spectate you.
I will.
Uncorded provinces count, yeah. So we're going to have to fight Mexico in the end. We just need white peas against Great Britain. That's a good one, dude. He watches my videos and I know it. I love you, Flory. Let's go. I'm missing parliament seats. There's three more. I'm missing two seats. I'm missing two seats. I'm missing one seat. There we go.
Yo, Habibi, everything good?
Yeah, I just got 50k manpower. Check that out.
Oh, shit. Yeah, okay. So you haven't unpaused yet, right?
Yes.
Okay, okay. We're just, you know, we thought we had some technical difficulties. That's all I wanted to ask. Okay.
I have more manpower than I have. How did I do that?
I don't know, and that's what we're going to talk about right now. Bye-bye.
I think actually I should just go around fighting battles. All right, this is gonna look crazy. Actually, wait, cancel.
30 minutes left.
American morale! Oh, I built the wrong thing. Okay, we're just gonna have to roll with it. Alright, I got 15 minutes to conquer New Spain, dude. my capital.
Maybe 10 minutes left. I'm gonna have to click so fast. Thank you.
I need to stop accidentally paying loans. That's not good.
I got 5 minutes left, and I'll also give you a 2 minute warning.
Thank you. Red Hawk is stuck! Oh, that's not good. Red Hawk, you're stuck! I can't pause. Okay, I can now.
Two-minute warning. You got a two-minute warning.
Red Hawk is stuck, dude. I can't unpause. I can't go past speed 2. This is so bad, dude.
1 minute warning.
Dude, I can't go past speed 1. I'm stuck. This is so sad.
I'm so sorry.
I can't go. I can rush this fort. Come on. Red Hawk, you bastard. Oh my god. Oh my god. Red Hawk lagging. Red Hawk's lagging. Oh man,
stop,
I don't.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
You fucked me! It's okay. I lost. Why did England enforce on me? Gapped.
66 provinces versus 274 over in Habibi's game. Habibi, let's go with you first. What were the issues you were facing right there at the end?
You were the issue.
You kept slowing me down to speed 1.
How did I do that?
I don't know, man. I don't know,
but
you know,
ladies and gentlemen, it is my fault that I also got
enforced by England white piece. If I didn't do that, I would have had Canada, and then if we didn't slow down, I could have gotten California, more Mexico. But I think he would have still won even
Laurie,
after that.
Laurie,
so
just
I'm
to catch
gonna...
you up, Habib managed to get a whopping 630 provinces. He's completely.
Oh my god!
it was very, very close, but he got
600.
Nah, he got enforced on by Britain for Newfoundland and was not able to get into
that war. I
think
that was the biggest.
It was that and a California at the end was the difference.
Now, boys, from me right here. You both stayed in the Independence War quite long. Do you both think that was a mistake?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely. Should have just day one put suggestion.
Yeah. That would have been so much faster because it takes like 5 seconds to siege down a colony. Yeah. And it took me like 20 minutes to get out. And then I had this dumbass idea that I needed to actually win the war because Britain didn't have a Louisiana. And I'm like, well, I want those 3 provinces, which makes no sense when there's a 500 province Mexico right next to you ready to be taken. So,
That's true.
I mean, that's
you know,
the
I
case.
Was ready to do it right from the beginning. And then Chatter said, oh, I think it's an independence war. And then I looked at the thing and it said Independence War. I was like, wait, do I have to win? Yeah. I thought I didn't have to win.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then 5 minutes in, I realized I didn't have to win and I just accepted the demands.
Yeah.
It is a rough one, but hey, that's why we wanted to chuck you into a 776. But chaps, even though like the province count was different, just because it's colonies, that's what made a difference. It was so incredibly close. Easily the best duel that we've had thus far.
Sure.
So thank
for
you both very, very much for both of those. And Habibi, you still do have your 2 points, so you're still in contention for the title.
We'll see.
And hopefully Hawk won't lag you out next time, man. Hawk is just, you know.
I want Leith as my observer next time.
Hey, I'm just saying, it's that kindred. we can make that happen. We can absolutely
I always want Hawk. Or Leith, actually.
Okay,
I want Hawk. Yeah, but this was perfect for me. And there was only a little bit of stutter this time.
Listen, you know I'm tight with Flory like that, bro.
He does have a bet.
Hawk, no longer my friend. Best friend. Late is now my best friend. Friendship with Hawk ended.
I'll see you next time on Habibi's Daycare.
Oh, no. Let's go. I've been replaced. You'll see Late on the next Habibi's Daycare.
Oh, no. Well, chaps, thank you both very much. And we'll see
you
both next week.
Congrats.
GG, bro. Yep. That was intense.
That was very intense.
Oh, good game, man. Good game.
Good game.
That was way rougher than I thought it was going to be. And then I had this stupid idea to actually land on Britain. And I did land, surprisingly, because he keeps his entire navy in the Irish Sea for some reason. And I hired a bunch of mercenaries. I hired the Independent Company, the Grand Company, and the Free Company. And I assaulted London, but I didn't do the trick where you consolidate correctly. And
you lost your entire army.
Americans died in London. It's so stupid. And I was like, oh, fuck this. I'm out. I did get a white piece, though, but I think it would have been... What would also have been faster is to just speed 5, because it's not like they're going to threaten you in any way. Because he, like, lands once, and then that's it. I'll be back tomorrow, guys. I'll be back tomorrow.
I'll be back tomorrow, too, guys.
Now, BB will also be back tomorrow. I completely forgot I was killing a bush job.
Was Cuba a waste of time, you think?
Nah. Well, not really. Because it only took, like, a couple seconds.
Yeah, I don't think it was someone in my chat saying that we fucked up going for Cuba, but I don't think so.
No. I did that at the very end, like, really quickly. I think that's worth it. I don't know about the others, though. Because if it takes you a lot of time to, like, land on them. But that is also the issue of you need to piece out everything at the same time. Because I'm sitting at 456% overextension.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I have Rebels enforcing demands. So you kind of have to take it real slow at the start. And New Granada took forever. Just because it takes, like, 10 hours to walk down there. That was... very frustrating. Anyway, GG, man.
GG. I don't think it counts until it finishes, because they're using the thing. I don't know, let's figure out, Yusuf.
Yeah, I think I should have done my strat. I was like, really stupid, I should have just right off the day one.
But Mega Dwarf, what do you mean? I decked both of them, so if Great Britain declared war on me, Glory War won by 100 provinces. I think I needed to rush the capital and just take what I could and then truce break, or just deck it again. That's the thing with these colonial wars. You take the capital, and then you get, like, 60% war score. You can take, like, almost all of their country, and then you can go again. They don't seem to enforce peace until the war has lasted a while. The problem with Newfoundland is he has a level 8 fort, dude. That was actually a huge problem. Not even Mexico had level 8 forts. I got California. Here, let's see. Let's do this for cope mode. I got California and Newfoundland. How much would we be at? Oh, sucks. I would have won. No, I think I did pretty good, honestly. No, I'm not going to say, oh, we could have done this. I should have done this. Oh, this sucks. No, I actually did pretty good, guys. That was pretty good. I had a lot of fun. That was a fun challenge. Next time you use mobile data, it would be even worse. I'm telling you, Mega Dwarf, if you rush the capital. Wait. Look, he did both wars at the same time, too. His micro is better, dude. His EU4 micro is better. Look, Quebec is a level 8 fort. You need so many dudes to siege it. But once you siege it, you get 60% war score because it's the only fort in all of him. And you can take everything except for one province. That's what I was saying. He took more troops too and took more debt earlier. And he was able to play speed 5, dude. Oh, come on. I don't think I'm going to be able to win this Parabellum, guys. I need to move to Europe and then I'll be able to win Master of Universalis. Look, he's able to speed 5. How? If I go to speed 5, it goes into speed 1. Red Hawk is lagging. Yeah, because I don't pause. My methodology is to not pause. Look, it's 35 war score for everything except for one province. No, for some reason, I got into my head in the last second. Right before going in, I was like, dude, I'm just going to concede to England right away. But then I won a battle, and I was like, wait, can I win this war and get, like, a white piece? But no, that was stupid, dude. I should have just conceded to England right away. I need to move to Red Hawk's house. See, you take everything except for one province. Why leave one? Because in order to fully annex, the reason why you leave one province is because in order to man fully annexation, you need to, like, be dominant. You need, like, 90% war score. But if you take the capital, you get, like, 40, 50 war score, and then you just take the provinces are so low war score, you can take everything except one province. Yeah, what Stella said.